My lovely assistant Libby, we're going to talk today about a subject that's near and dear to many people's hearts, core training. All right. Now, one of the big errors that I see in core training is people doing exercises that are way too advanced for them. And you know, one of the big reasons why I want to illustrate in this video. All right. So I'm going to use Olivia sort of as my example here. It's kind of a typical woman, you know, that I train, in very good shape, you know, very strong, great muscle tone. However, there's one big thing that we look at that is inhibiting her progress in this particular area. Olivia, let me have you turn to the side here. Now, Olivia, I want you to raise your arms above your head. As you can see here, Olivia has what is called an anterior pelvic tilt, okay? So an anterior pelvic tilt, we have a large arch in her back, okay? What that ends up doing is putting our core in a bad position to strengthen. Okay, so the first step in getting the core that you want, kind of reestablishing core strength, is to get the body back in more of a neutral alignment where, okay, you can drop the ribs down, you sort of just drop the ribs down a little bit and straighten the body out somewhat. Okay, so everything looks like more alignment, also gonna give you a flat stomach. Gonna give you two drills to do just that. All right, so look at it. The one back here, we're just gonna put your feet up in the chair. This drill is called 90-90 breathing. Okay, if you do this, is placing your feet up on the chair like it's gonna flatten your back out. All right, now we're gonna re-engage your core muscles through some targeted breathing. All right, so Libby, I want you to put your hands in your stomach. All right, you're gonna take a deep breath into your belly. Fill your belly with air. Now, you're gonna purse your ribs and blow out while pressing your back into the ground. All right, think about tightening your abs. You're just gonna do that several times. Couple deep breaths. One of the functions of our abs is what is called force exhalation. So as she's blowing out and tightening, that's telling my body to wrap my abs around the spine, or wrap her abs around her spine, like a weight belt to flatten her stomach. Okay? Generally, with the breathing and blowing thing, we want to think about taking a deep breath in for about 3 seconds, and then a long exhale, blowing out as hard as you can, tightening as hard as you can, again for about 3 seconds. Alright? Generally, with this drill, we're going to do this for about maybe 15 to 20 breaths, and then we're going to move to a core exercise. Alright? So that takes us to our next exercise. So, Libby, let's get you on your back over here. Our next step is to do what we call finding neutral spine. So I want you to lie your back here, Libby. You're going to put your hands behind your back like this. All right? Just right behind the palm above that. Now, I want you to arch your back as much as you can. Okay? Now, feel the pressure off your hand. This is the position you were in, and this is the position that we want to stay away from as we do our core training. Now, I want you to press your hands in through your back into your hands as much as you can. Okay? You feel the pressure on your hands now. Now, just arch just slightly. Okay? Holding that position. Now, the goal with this is to make sure that you don't change position. So your back stays the same way and you feel the same pressure, okay? Good. Now, and if you start to arch, you know that you've gone too far and we're not using our abs anymore. Okay, so now, what we're going to do, let's lift your feet off the ground. You're just going to take, again, about 3 deep breaths. Deep breath in. Blow out the tight. Good. Deep breath in. Blow out the tight. One more time. Deep breath in. Blow out the tight. Still feel the same pressure? This exercise can be made harder by extending the legs out. All right, one more time. Deep breath in. Two more times. And blow. One more time. Deep breath in. And blow. Still feel the same pressure? If I wanted to make it super, super hard, I could get her feet closer to the ground. Because you find as you're starting to arch, they lower down. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Right. So for you at home, it's gonna, the ideal is to just kind of find your position and breathe your way through it. Once you could do about 10 breaths in a particular position, extend your legs out, try to make it harder for about 3 sets, all right? Those two exercises combined, the 90-90 as a warm-up and the dead bug hold, are two great ways to start your core in the right direction.
That was just under 4 minutes.